Hello friends, in the previous session, we discussed about the conflict serializability and the precedence graph method, which is a shortcut technique to find out whether a particular schedule is conflict serializable or not, and to find out its corresponding serial order if that schedule is serializable. In this particular session, we'll be discussing some examples based on the same concept. So let's see, we have the example of two schedules given over here. So, for the first example, there are some read-write operations listed over here. What is the first step? First of all, we'll be discovering what are the conflict pairs in this example. So, in this example, we can see that this R1 basically means the read operation for first transaction. Now, this read operation is being executed on this data item Y. And then we have W2Y basically means a write operation on transaction 2 on data item Y. Fine. So now this operation is being performed on the same data item, that is Y, and it is a read-write pair. So this is a conflict pair, that means. So now what we'll be doing, we'll be drawing the edge corresponding to this conflict pair. So the edge will go from T1 to T2. So this is the edge corresponding to it. Now we see there is another conflict pair over here, which is R2X and W1X. Again, the conflict pair operation is on the same data item X, and it is from T2 transaction to T1 transaction. So edge now in this case will move from this to this. As you can see that this graph is clearly a cyclic graph. This is a cycle, right? This is a loop. This is a cycle. So that means this is an example of a non-conflict serializable schedule, because if the graph would have been acyclic, then it would have been conflict serializable. But otherwise, it is always a non-conflict serializable schedule. So this is for now a non-conflict serializable schedule example. Let's see the next example. In this example, again, we'll check for the conflict pairs first. So this R2X and W1X are being performed on the same data item X, and the order is from 2 to 1, right? So we have drawn a conflict edge corresponding to it. Again, there is another conflict pair, which is W2Y and R1Y. Both the operations being performed on data item Y, and the order is from 2 to 1. So again, we have drawn another edge. But in this case, now the graph is acyclic. There is no loop being formed. Both the things are going from 2 to 1, right? So that means this is an acyclic graph. If this is an acyclic graph, then the schedule is conflict serializable. Then we'll follow the procedure to get a serial order. What was that procedure? First of all, we will remove the node with an end degree 0, which is T2 in this case. We'll remove T2, and then the other node left over here in this case is just T1. So the order is from T2 to T1. So this is how we solve for precedence graph method examples for various schedules. Hope you understood it clearly. We'll be discussing about view serializability in the next session to encounter or deal with the problem of non-conflict serializable schedules. Thank you, friends.